Welcome to vlog number one. Let's talk today about organization. Now, I've got ADHD and I work for myself full time, and those two things don't always go together. And one of the things I've done over the years to try and compensate for that and my general lack of organization has been to keep notes. I am an avid note taker. Everything in my life has a checklist. Everything in my life has some form of organization to it. Now, before, it used to be with things like this. Now, yeah, I mean, this isn't even half of it. I lived out of these things, and you know what? They served me really well. Every piece of every project I was working on was in one of these, and even down to little granular details. They were my main source of organizing myself, and I think that's really important. To have that granular detail, for me particularly. But these have their limits, because one, you have to have a pen, you have to have your notebook with you, and you've got to remember which out of the thousands of notebooks you've got it in. Now, obviously, one of those things, if you can't remember where the notebook is, that's a major problem. I was always looking for another solution, and, you know, I tried tons. None of them worked. Not a single one of them worked. But what did work, and what I've been using for the past couple of months now, is Notion. I am evangelical about Notion, and I'm really excited to show you some of the stuff that I do within it to work my creative studio, to work through my life, which is my kind of my second brain almost, and also to keep on top of my ADHD. Now, this video isn't sponsored. One of the things that I'm talking about today about Notion is the fact I'm off to the Notion Meetup. It's the very first one they've done in London, and it's going to be a really exciting time. There's a keynote speaker, a YouTuber called Ali Abdal, and he's going to be speaking about productivity, and there's going to be a chance to meet up with other creatives. It's going to be fun. So let's go and find out what that's all about, and then we'll get back to finding out what I do with Notion in my daily life in this studio. So here we are, the Broadgate Quarter. It's the Notion Meetup. It's the first in London. Let's see what it's like.
Ali Abdal. Thank you very much.
So that's me. I'm back from the Notion Meetup. It was really interesting. So many interesting people and so many great stories about how people are using this technology. It was really great to see. I'm going to grab myself some food and then I'm going to tell you a little bit about how I use Notion. Now, in my daily life, Notion is the glue that holds the ADHD madness together. And I do mean everything. It starts with my weekly task manager. Every job that's for work is lightly outlined in that. Using brief bullets, I break down the job and I give an idea of when each job is due, who it's for, whether it's client facing, internal, for one of my side hustles, or for a project outside of those boundaries. I love that planner as it allows me to see the jobs as a gallery all in one place. In a board that shows what's started, what's being worked on, what's been postponed or needs additional info, what's complete, as well as the more traditional timeline view, which is particularly useful if I'm working up against other people's deadlines. Then there's the habit tracker. This is like my idiot's guide to the day. I track all sorts of hard stops during the day, points which, though their timings might be the same or different every day, I will stop my day for a couple of seconds to a couple of hours each day to do. And they take all sorts of shapes. I'm tracking if I've taken my meds, whether I've been to the gym, whether I've completed my cardio, set time aside to reach the reading goal in my book app, practice my languages, plus loads of other bits and pieces. Now, I find these supremely useful because on days when I'm struggling with my ADHD, I'm still able to hang the rest of my day off those clearly defined micro goals. And that makes me feel at least like I'm meeting the basics of adult life. Beyond that, There's goal tracking, again, using planners that allow me to see all of my goals, the timelines and planners. There's individual databases for looking after projects. This channel has one that contains all the scripts, ideas, shooting schedules, sponsor details and more. And every other project or side hustle replicates that same pattern. The clothing label has one that's got access to all our supplier details. It's got templates, it's got boilerplate materials, it's got an archive of our stock and so on. Now, it's great to have that because it has some really cool integrations. I can integrate Dropbox, Zoom, Slack, GitHub, thousands of other partners. For no matter what it is, I can access everything, view it, modify it directly, and I have one centralized source of truth for that project. So I'm not having to rely on emails. I'm not having to go back to the client and ask what's what. I'm not having to go into a planner and figure out where I am. Everything is in one single place. And then there's everything else, from my gym routine to in-depth brand guides for my clients, to keeping tabs on what I'm reading, to planning out travel, adventures, business endeavors. For me, Notion is the only tool that's ever worked. Now, it does this because it's simple, yet really stunningly capable. It does exactly what you want it to do, from the very simple to the deeply complex. It has replaced thousands of other planners, notebooks, organizational systems, email systems, planning software that I have spent time and money trying to use, but they've never lived up to my needs, and they've never lived up to the storm that sometimes goes on inside my head. Now, if you're looking to take your organizational skills to the next level as we start 2023, I would highly recommend checking out Notion. Now, this video isn't sponsored, but you can find a link in the video details with a referral link to sign up. And that obviously helps me create more content. So please think of that if you choose to buy from Notion. You can, of course, try it for free. But if you do sign up through my link, it'll help me out. So with all that being said, it's time for me to check off my Notion tick box of the video uploaded. And until next time, I'm Neil Evans. Thanks for watching.